Whoa. I said, whoa. Did I hit my mic? What's good with y'all boys, man? I'm back with another Kid Reaction Meeting. What's good, family? How y'all feeling out there today, man? Look, man, I was supposed to been react to this, man. This is another video of the Isle of Man TT. Guy Martin crashed in 2010, bro. Now, I don't know nothing that happened, you feel me? I did hear about him crashing. Y'all did comment that in my past video. So, bro, I'm, interested to see what happened. Let's get straight into this video, man. If y'all new to the channel, bro, y'all like the content. If you like it, that like button for me, bro. You don't got to subscribe or nothing. Just hit the like button for me. Let's get straight into this car crash. I mean, this motorcycle crash, man. Let's get straight into it, though.
Senior TT race going
in just under an hour's time at 12:30, and we will of course give you all the build-up and the interviews as the riders get out.
By the way, bro, y'all already explained to me how the Isle of Man TT is, bro. Like the actual, man, it's deadly, bro. It's deadly. Y'all say people down there all the time, bro. People put their life on line for that race, bro. People put their life on line for that race, man. But let's get back into it, bro. Let's see what happened. It's an HD.
He's proved himself to be an absolute maestro around the mountain course.
And there is the number one machine of Bruce Anstey. The lap record still standing at 131.578 miles an hour. That's set by John McGuinness last year. Less than 10 seconds to go.
Well, I can tell the members of the Guy Martin fan club over there on the far side of Glen Country Road that their man is still...
Oh, they about to show, like, the whole race? I thought they just probably going to show, like, the crash part.
Last few seconds tick away. We watch the flag which drops, and we are now racing.
Bruce Anstey, mountain maestro, John McGuinness, now number three, Ian Lockhart. And that's Hutchie on the number four.
Okay.
And Cameron Donald. So Michael is away on the Honda. It's Guy Martin.
Seven people. Oh, eight people. I'm sorry. Damn, boy. I heard they go like 200, right? 200 miles per hour. Bro, you got to be a different breed to ride this, bro. God damn, boy, they going fast.
And a tight line in for number 8, Guy Martin. 131 mile an hour lap for Guy. 131.108. That's Guy Martin's fastest.
Oh, Guy Martin is number 8.
And he's absolutely on song today. About those guys on the 8 and 10 plates, Guy Martin and Connor Cummins, but it's so close right behind them. Hutchie and John McGuinness are right there in the mix. Connor has gone into the lead. Connor has snatched the lead from Guy Martin, but there's 0.58 seconds in it.
Well, he about to hit the ground. Only take one slip up, bro, when you going that fast, boy. He floating though, bro. Definitely floating. Ah, that's great talent right there, bro. Damn.
Of seconds because of the bungalow, Guy Martin has narrowed the gap on Connor Cummins to just 1/10 of a second. That's all there is. It's still desperately tight.
Guy right in front of me here now, red torpedo on the back of his leathers, and yeah, just watch that speed, go on.
And Guy Martin, let me just give you his details, 130.642, and he was the race leader at Crofton Motor, but still waiting for Connor. Connor's here, now 130.278.
A brand new tyre in for Guy, he fires up and he is away right now, so great pit stop by the Wilson Craig team, and it's the McAdoo boys who run it now. Trying to up Mark, and Mark just says, go, 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 she fires, and the big man is away now.
He's floating. They not catching that boy Martin, boy. Martin gone.
And the road goes quiet here for a moment or two. But we're still waiting, machine number 8.
So was everybody rooting for Martin? Is Martin like a, you know, a crowd favorite? You feel me? Let me know in the comment section, bro.
So we don't appear to have a Guy Martin here. Guy Martin is missing.
He's missing.
Well, back here in the grandstand, we're not sure if we've got a red flag situation. The race has been stopped because a fire engine has to go onto the track. It's clearly something very serious at Balaguerre. It's only the second senior race in 100 years to be red flagged.
Pits in into Balaguerre. And Guy Martin hasn't reached Balaguerre.
Red flag, boys. Red flag. Red flag. I guess that means they stopping the race.
We believe it's Guy Martin. He's crashing the bike, set fire to a field, and that's one of the only times they'll put red flags out.
Right.
Wrenching for everyone. The team are pacing up and down. You can see the team boss's head down, not knowing what's going on. I mean, nobody knows any better than anybody.
First we knew about it was when Guy didn't arrive at Glen Helen. You like to think that it's a mechanical failure rather than a crash.
So. Right.
Then we heard the hedge was on fire at Glen Vine.
Only riders and officials are allowed in the park fermé area. Everybody else out, please. Thank you.
You could see the fire in the distance about a mile away. There was smoke, and one of the hay bales was on fire, and they slowed us way down. And then I thought, okay, well, there's a hay bale on fire, and then, well, there's the bike in somebody's yard. And I'm like, okay, we're past the incident.
Wow.
A quarter mile later, there was Guy. And I was like, it.
There was an incident. Guy was missing, so it had to be him. He crashed at something like 170 miles an hour, so he was off at that speed. And of course you worry, you know, you don't jump from a bike at 170 miles an hour and get up again. So yes, we were worried.
Paul Dobbs crashed there last night, and you know, he didn't make it. So. Fingers crossed for Guy, it's hit and miss there, you know. There's no run out as there isn't anywhere on the circuit here, and Guy seems to have made a little bit of a rider error sort of thing, and he's gone into the wall. It's not looking good. I came up on the circuit, you know, it just looks like a bomb's exploded when out goes on here. The wall and all the bales were on fire, you know, Guy's laid there in the track, his bike's split in pieces, like it's, you know, it's horrendous. Yeah, everyone's fingers crossed at the minute to see how Guy is.
Right. Wow.
How it is, sort of thing. We all enter it. There's no gun to our heads to enter. We all love it. And at the end of the day, if it goes wrong and the worst does happen, you've died a happy man. Like, you know, the show's going on. We've got 4 laps coming here. We're at 3 o'clock start. You know, it'll be no slower.
Again, it was the sound and the blur, but the blur stopped. He's coming around the corner. Good race line. Really good race line, in all fairness to him. And he was flying around. Bike comes down, kicks the bike away, and the bike literally turns into a fireball on impact. It's like the start of a TV program, like an all-action TV program, where the screen is filled with flames, and this silhouette comes towards us out of a waist height, and it's Guy. And I'm thinking, oh, here we go, got a job. Yeah, the first thing that springs to my mind, like. So I reach around, grab my orange box. The med box. I turn around there, and Guy's flying past me, followed by a bike which is on fire, and it just screams past me, and then the bike goes over to one side, and it's still in flames. I mean, it's black smoke everywhere, it's flames, a heck of a mess on there, and Guy's in the middle. I told him, I'm not going to cut your leathers, you know, because, you know, I need to check you over the first of all. And he said, you know, oh, don't cut my leathers, don't cut my leathers. Now, I understand that because I'm a biker, like, and that's the last thing I'd want is somebody to cut my leathers. But he was good. He was good.
Oh, you survived?
Definitely somebody's up there watching him. No doubt about it. Lucky guy.
Wow. Oh, he survived that race, bro? That's crazy. The whole time I'm thinking he did. Well, I'm thinking he died, bro. Going that fast? That's wild, man. I do not know what this is right here. But look, man. One slip up, bro, can mess up everything, bro. Definitely when you're going that fast, man. He was killing it, too. He get to going past everybody, bro. God damn, bro. Send me more reactions on the Iron Man TT. I want to react to, like, the little side cars and everything, bro. And that was wild, bro. I definitely thought that he actually passed. I'm not even going to lie to y'all, man. So if y'all new to the channel, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, man. I appreciate y'all, boys. And I love y'all, man. I'm out, man. One.